现在就是2020年，全球的温升已经是1.1度了。如果不采取措施的话，人们排放的空间只有15年到30年左右了。所以说，你必须要采取措施，才能够实现这个目标，就是把不可能变成可能。
嗯，太艰巨了哈。
对，那你就得必须要转型和创新。
那在这个阶段呢，我们想来讨论一下解决的方案。我们先来看看每一年人类排放的温室气体是由怎样的一些部分组成的。Of course, different countries and different regions may have different situations. Like California, as I understand, transportation is the biggest greenhouse gas emission source. Is that right, Governor?
Yes. It's when you take all costs in producing cars and trucks and buses, maybe even trains, and then all the people burning oil or gas to make those cars and vehicles go forward, it's 50%. So California is committed by 2035 to have zero emission from all its cars.
But Governor, is there a sense of frustration when you see that the charging stations for clean energy in California has only reached 19,000, although you wish to set the target at 250,000?
We have a long way to go. Frustrated, I'm worried America's using too much oil, that we're having too many cars that burn gasoline. We have a long way to go. If you want to be frustrated, I can be frustrated by everybody, but I'd rather look creatively at what can be done. And so much can be done with technology and with a new awareness of how to live in the world in a more harmonious way. So we're not there yet. We're not even close, but we can get there. I have great confidence in that.
David and Susan, as we know that the Rockefeller family achieved its wealth originally from the oil industry. So how has the family divested into clean energy despite of this origin of the wealth?
My great-grandfather, who found the Standard Oil companies that had impact both in the West and in China. And it was a revolution in energy at the time and a great gift, frankly, to mankind. What neither he nor anybody at the time realized is as population grew and as energy demand grew, it would have such deleterious impact on the environment. But that's something that's very clear to his great-grandchildren and great-great-grandchildren who now have persuaded the philanthropic foundations that were created from oil money to divest themselves. Several of them have, the Rockefeller Foundation, the Rockefeller Brothers Fund, the Rockefeller Family Fund, are all but completely divested of fossil fuel stocks, because we believe that the reality looked at from today is that those are bad long-term investments, certainly for the planet and ultimately for the shareholders as well. I think my great-grandfather would be proud of his progeny for doing this.
Understood. 谢主任，其实刚才那个 Brown 州长也提到了这个煤炭的问题。那我们也注意到中国领导人呢已经承诺呢不在海外兴建新的煤电项目。但是就煤炭而言，在中国的能源结构当中还是一个压舱石的一个地位。所以您觉得这个世界还需要听到的声音或者了解的情况是怎样的呢？
刚才这个视频上把这个排放的结构这个显示出来，它主要是消费端。实际上，从这个供给端呢，实际上它大头还是能源，能源活动这个造成的排放。现在 IPCC 做了一个评估，现在就是2020年，全球的温升已经是1.1度了。如果不采取措施的话，人们排放的空间只有15年到30年左右了。所以说，你必须要采取措施， 才能够实现这个目标，就是把不可能变成可能。
嗯，太艰巨了哈。
对，那你就得必须要转型和创新。
嗯，
转型首先要在能源要转型，所以我们讲能源要进行一场变革。习主席讲不是变革，是革命。
嗯，
把我们的电力结构调，要以化石能源为主，变成以可再生能源为主。在这个过程当中呢，你要一定要这个淘汰落后的，发展这可再生能源。我们淘汰的这个火电机组1.2亿，
嗯，
什么概念？英国全国的这个装机容量不到1亿，这就是这么一个概念。也就是说，我们确定的目标是非常艰巨的，而且呢，我们要努力要把它实现。另外呢，国外我们不再建这个煤电了，
嗯。
国外不建煤电，它有它的困难。全球在生态脆弱地区生活的人33亿到35亿，而且有些国家现在连能源都没有。比如说我去尼泊尔，尼泊尔就很缺电，它这个首都大街上就没有路灯，只有总统府前面有几盏这个太阳能的这个路灯。是谁啊？是我们西藏自治区送给他们的。
嗯，
所以这就是说，如果要真正给它解决，必须有一个过程，这个过程要解决技术创新，要解决储能的问题，解决电网的安全问题，输配的问题。
所以我看到您说我们要只争朝夕，但是的确不是一朝一夕就能够一步到位的哈。陈来教授，从文化的角度您也可以来解读一下，就是中国在人均 GDP 是一个中等收入国家的这个时候，做出了这种主动的调整，它意味着什么？
这个政策吧，也反映了中国的文化。
嗯，
从前有句话叫做善为人先，不落事后，就是好的事我们要争先，不管它短期内对我自己是不是有益，但是只要是好的，是善的事，善为人先，不落事后，不能落后。但是在一个更大的共同体，人类的生存的共同体，人类的命运的共同体来看，是吧，这件事是必要的，是好的，那我就应该首先比别人更先去做这件事，这就叫善为人先。
And Susan and David, share with us some of, you know, the inspirational stories that takes place around the world. What are some of the innovations, breakthroughs, new ideas, new solutions that you can share with us?
When I look at that chart that you had up,So many of the emissions relate to the food system. And I think that there's a huge unlocking of potential and innovation in food, both on the local level, and in addressing, global supply chain issues, innovations in refrigeration, all the different things that were listed. There's some really interesting entrepreneurs in China. There's David Young with Green Common.There's a lot of innovation funds in the United States looking at cellular agriculture, looking at plant-based innovation.
You have initiated a program called Kiss the Ground, which aims to sustain healthy soil, which is the basis for the food, for human beings, basically. Have you achieved some encouraging progress on that?
I think it's, you know, there's a real need to raise awareness abouta lot of these chemicals and pesticides. Obviously, that was something that started with Silent Spring with Rachel Carson, who was my hero, who actually propelled the beginning of the environmental, you know, grassroots environmental movement and the Environmental Protection Agency. But I think there's lots of renewed interest in regenerating soil. Some of the statistics say that in 60 years, we have 60 years left of topsoil, and we have to find ways to regenerate and make our soils more healthy and also mitigate against drought. If you have a healthier soil structure, it can retain more water. So there's a lot of benefits. And I think that it's something that David and I are interested in. We have a 2,000 acre farm in upstate New York. So we're trying on a personal level,to actually apply these principles and also invest in companies that are actually addressing some of the global supply chain issues, because you obviously can't get everything locally. but how do you make a more efficient global food system more sustainable? And I think there's a lot of innovation happening.
So we need to use our science, not just for weapons of war, but for weapons of climate change, of curbing carbon emissions, of new vehicles, new technology, new ways of living, new values. That is a revolution. It is a transformation, and it can be done. It just takes understanding, insight, wisdom, and commitment on the part of people in not in one part of the world, but in many parts of the world.
Thank you. 谢主任可以跟我们分享一下，最近一段时间您有没有听到一些能够让人感到很有信心的一些在科技和模式创新方面的举动呢？
其实现在这个转型创新呢，已经成了一个大的趋势，而且它也带来了一个大的市场、大的竞争的一个平台。这个，比如说这个节能，提高能源的利用效率，这个潜力非常大。现在这个可再生能源，我们除了光，这个光伏发电、这个水力发电、这个风力发电、潮汐发电，还有这个生物质能发电之外，现在呢又有了一个氢能。氢能就是氯氢，通过可再生能源电解水产生氢。现在还有一个概念呢，就是循环经济。也就是说那潜力也很大，它又造就出一个新的产业，带来新的就业机会。真正要技术创新，它是可以解决很多问题的。另外呢，还要制度创新。所以在减排这个问题上，政府的责任就是确定目标，出台鼓励性的、限制性的和禁止性的政策，特别是经济政策。经济政策作为杠杆，它可以撬动你投入一，可以撬动10%的这个作用。所以这个
要靠市场的机制去运作，
靠市场的机制去运作，还要一发挥企业家的作用。所以这些问题只要制度上、技术上进行创新，大家的有政治意愿，很多问题啊，
这是全社会的意愿，
全社会的意愿，只要你这个努力了，而且呢还要国际合作，这要做到了，就把不可能争取变成可能，这就是靠大家的努力。